What is default mechanism for route selection of a router? What is route preference? In simple words, how does a router decide which path to take? For example, if one router has three paths, so how does it choose? There are three main selection criteria on which router decides. The first one is called prefix length. Second one is based on admin distance. Third one is based on the metric. So I will give you some examples briefly, and the link to all the examples and all the exercises is there in the description as well. You can go through that in detail. So prefix length, first of all, this is a very common misconception. Whenever somebody asks you or even me that which route will be selected. So for example, if we have 1, 2, and 3 routes and router has to choose which path to take, if the admin distance of this one is 1, this one 2, and this one is 3, we will say, okay, it will go with the lowest admin distance. So we directly jump to the admin distance. But before admin distance, there is another thing which is more preferred in the routing mechanism, which is called as prefix length. So you must always see for the prefix length, smallest subnet. You shouldn't just jump onto the admin distance, right? So let me give you this example. Of course, everybody knows what is prefix length. Prefix length means that if /32, if there is a route which says 10.0.0.0.1 and /32, this one is more specific route, more reliable route. Why? Because it is telling you only about one host. If the same route is learned with the higher 10.1 or maybe 10.0, let's say this is the network now. So slash, if I make it /30, this one is less preferred as compared to /32. Why? Because it is telling you about two hosts. You will have to find your required host. Similarly, if there is a third one, 10.0.0.0/29. /29 means 2 raised to power, you know, 30, let's calculate. So 32 minus 29 is equal to 3, and 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. So it means it will, and 8 minus 2, it is giving us 6 hosts to find our required host. So which one is more reliable? This one is more reliable, of course, /32. So we have to go with the smallest subnet, with the longest prefix match. Let me give you some example on each of them, and then I'll tell you the answer as well. Okay. So let's say this is an example. So which path will be preferred? Can somebody answer me? If you can answer, you can write in the comments as well, or you can send me direct WhatsApp. My WhatsApp is also there in the comments. So in here, a data packet comes here on R1. Now R1 has three paths, path number 1, path number 2, and path number 3. It has to make its decision. So based on the route preference, the default mechanism, the default programming which has been done into the routing, into this router, it will decide based on that, right? So then it will check, okay, I am having three paths to reach to this network. Finally, I have to reach there. I am learning a route via /26, via /25, and /24 as well. So /21 is giving me less number of hosts. It is telling me to reach to my network, I have to find to reach to my required destination of a host, I will have to find within less number of host. 25 means broad category, 24 means 254, we know all. So it will choose based on this one. It will not check the admin distance. Admin distance come in the, it comes in the second preference. So the first one, if this route goes down, then it will choose number 2 as the second preference. If this one also goes down, then finally it will choose this one. But first preference will be to /26. If there was something with /29, then it will choose 29. It will be more preferred, right? So longest prefix match, we have to go with that one. The second priority will always be given to the admin distance, like what you are thinking. So this router has three paths again. This is the second example, path number 1, path 2, and path 3, right? So 1, 2, and 3. This, the first one is being learned via RIP. So RIP means the admin distance is 120. OSPF means admin distance is 110, and BGP means the admin distance is 200. So which path will be chosen? Of course, this path will be chosen, number 2, because it is via OSPF. So second priority is with the admin distance. Lowest admin distance is always preferred. So 110 is the lowest of those three. The third one If the admin distance is equal, then it starts looking inside the routing protocol. So in this third example, you will be seeing that there are three paths again, path 1, 2 and 3. All are learned through OSPF. All are, let's say, having /26/26/26. So in this case, there is a tie. Then it will start looking into the OSPF routing protocol, into its metric. The metric of OSPF we all know is cost. So this one has cost of 100 as an example, 200 and 300. So which one will be chosen? Lowest cost will be preferred. So this path will be chosen as first preference, right? So let me go to the summary now to sum up the concept. In here you can see I have prepared a table actually. In this one you can see, so which path will be chosen out of the three? Of course /26/26. Which path will be chosen out of this? Of course OSPF, because the admin distance is same and prefix is all same. So I have kept other parameters same and then I have just modified one so that you could identify. Then in the third example, so prefix is same, admin distance is same, and then the last thing is only the metric. So the metric of 100 will be chosen as an example. These are the answer of all of them, this one. So here the first priority will be given to the this one, but out of those three, the first one will be given to the longest prefix. If prefix are same, you can see all are same, then it will go for the admin distance. But if admin distances are same, it will go for the last option, which is the metric. If it is OSPF, the metric will be cost. If it is RIP protocol, so if these were all RIP, then it will check for the hop count, whichever will have the less hops.